there is a need to be focused on the e-waste. They may be like a, they're asking the, this these kind of the question. India e-waste generate कर रहा है किस COP में add किया गया e-waste को. So before going to the topic, we will look into the question. So try to give the answer. Only the authorized dismantler and recyclers can collect the e-waste in India. Initially, it was not mentioned in the Basel Convention, but in the 2008, it was mentioned in the Basel Convention as well. This is not related to the e-waste. This is related to the plastic waste. So look, we will look, I will not be going to teach here the e-waste management rule in the India. So you need to be make the points of the e-waste management rules out of 2016. Usme 8-10 point aapko note down karne honge. I will let you know about the some of the points, the key points, which can be the most important for the examination. Okay. So the e-waste, sabko pata hoga, electronic waste. These are discarded electronic appliances or the like the mobile phones, like the computers, or some of the chips and some of the PCs and some of the refrigerator. These are come from the e-waste. There. Law of the manage to e-waste India mein 2011 se hain. Only authorized dismantlers and recyclers can collect the e-waste. Then there was the e-waste management rules of 2016 was enacted in the 2017. And India ka sabse pehla e-waste cleaning was established into the Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal. E-waste cleaning, jahan pe waste ko collect kiya jayega, usko jitna bhi uske usage ka hoga, that we will take it out and other will be the recycled according to the e-waste cleaning. So the first fact, e-waste management rule was implemented in 2017. But comes year 2016, e-waste clinic, sabse pehla Bhopal, only registered recycler can collect the e-waste. Originally in the Basel Convention in the 1992, it did not mention about the e-waste, but it addressed the issue of the e-waste in the 2006 in the COP 8. And the Nairobi Declaration was adopted at the COP 9 of the Basel Convention on the control of the transboundary movement of the hazardous waste. It also included the e-waste. जो बेसल कन्वेंशन है और नैरोबी डिक्लेरेशन है दोनों में ईवेस्ट को इंक्लूड किया गया. इट एम्ड एट क्रिएटिंग अ इनोवेटिव सॉल्यूशन फॉर द एनवायरमेंटली साउंड मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वेस्ट. सो इफ देयर इज एनी स्टेटमेंट रिलेटेड टू द नैरोबी डिक्लेरेशन और द बेसल कन्वेंशन बोथ आर इंक्लूडिंग द ईवेस्ट. ईवेस्ट इन इंडिया, देयर इज सम ऑफ द फैक्ट अबाउट द ईवेस्ट इन इंडिया. इंडिया हैज द थर्ड लार्जेस्ट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर इन द वर्ल्ड after China and the United States. Number one is the China, second is the United States, and third is the India. India produces about the 4 million metric ton of the e-waste per year, and the only the 1.5% of the e-waste can be recycled. Waste generated or recycled in India. So there can be statements, India is recycling the 50% of their e-waste. Okay, so it's only the 1.5%. Maybe at the influence in the examination pressure, mein aap kar dogi, haan, theek hai. India is the hub of electronics now, na? Next is the Global Waste Initiative 50 by 2050. It was introduced in the COP27. It will leverage voluntary engagement from the over the 180 countries, and its aim to treat and recycle at least of the 50% of the solid waste produced in the Africa. It is specifically to Africa. So you should remember about the Global Waste Initiative 50 by 2050. It is specifically to the Africa. 50% of the waste produced in Africa should be aimed to treat and recycle under the Global Waste Initiative 2050 under the COP27. So even from the Paris climate deal se aapko continuous dekhna hai, what are the major outcomes of the other COPs as well, na? Because they are not asking the question in the last 3-4 years of the COP. Maybe this time there is a higher chance there will be a question on the COP as well.